like touch you.
Right. He has almost no physical attacks. His jump attacks are all magic based, which is just a really cool touch. And even his dash is a teleport.
Yeah, so nobody else has that.
It's now, very, very unique.
Is he invulnerable during that dash?
He is not. It functions like a dash, right. But it's just a really cool visual touch for almost all of his moves. Thanks, Derek.
Sorry.
There's one thing about playing in this game. When Derek's in the room and he has a controller,
yeah,
he'll forget what we're trying to do and be like, I gotta push some buttons.
That's me, I push buttons.
He's just a childlike hype duel.
Yeah, thank you.
I do want to say that when we were giving the comics out and everybody, you know, wanted them, the stream chat was just blowing by.
Well, it's good stuff.
Good stuff.
It's because people are having fun.
I'm excited about it. Mm-hmm. So, I talked to John Edwards about this actually too, and like one of his new design ideas, well, like he really wanted a lot of magic to be shown.
Right.
Like most of the ways he moves and interacts are magic.
Yeah, and it really comes through. It's a really cool effect. Like his 113 ends in kind of a projectile attack and he can actually charge it. Or you can even cancel it and then go and do a pressure or a guessing game. His 112 ends in this big pillar of fire.
Oh, do the 2-1-1-1-3.
Yeah, this is my favorite. Goes into the zap.
Right.
That's a really good combo ender.
Love it.
And his back one, down 3, up 3, actually ends in a stomp.
But it's a magical stomp.
But it's a magical stomp. It's a magical stomp.
A stomp? Brought to you by magic.
No.
Yeah, his back two is a really good anti-air that's, again, he's not making physical contact, it's a pillar. Even his 4-3 and his back threes are magical infused back threes and 4-3s.
Pure magic.
Pure magic.
Okay, moving along.
So, his special moves are where he really shines. Mm-hmm. He has some of the best long distance special moves. His fireball is very, very quick.
I like to call that the pew.
The pew, yeah, I do that while playing.
Pew, 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 pew.
It has a very fast recovery. It's very hard for the opponent to deal with. And the meter burn one actually shoots 3.
That's the pew, pew, pew.
That's the pew, 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 right. So the idea is the opponent's trying to get in, and if you think they're gonna commit to dashing or jumping, you go with the 3 and they'll take a lot of damage.
So would you say, like, of the characters we've shown, he's kind of the first true zoner, or
he's what I would call a hard zoner. That is his. That's what he does.
Okay.
So his second projectile is a displacer orb, which is a slower moving, bigger orb that he can then follow behind it or do his other projectile behind. He can do the 3-1, and that'll come on force the opponent to take action, or he can actually use a bar meter and stop it in place at any time. So he could stop it really close and then hide behind it. Or he could stop it right in front of the opponent. Or he could not stop it at all, and the opponent has to kind of guess which version of his projectile he's going to do.
Awesome. Some people are on the chat are saying that they really like the look of Fate's magic.
Yeah, in my opinion, he has some of the coolest effects in the game. It looks great.
And little effects team, right?
Yeah. Big shout.
And I do want to say, I hope to have some of the effects team on at some point, because just a quick sub, I'm just going to break off real quickly. You know, the characters are the characters. You guys design them and you make them fight. One of the things that really gives them their personality is the effects team. Like, they really make what you guys do sing. Just like, I mean, really everybody in the building.
Yes, absolutely.
Does that. But we do, the effects team are a very big part of how the game looks.
Mm-hmm.
So we're hoping to have some of them on soon to talk about stuff.
And there's absolutely gorgeous effects in this game.
And I love the details and the animation that have a personality come out. Like, just look at his back walk, how he actually moves while he's back walking, doing his little magical stuff.
We talked to Nick about how the fact that, like, the thing that makes the characters so much fun in Injustice 2 is that they play well, they're fun to play, but they're so deeply, like, made.
Their personality is
it flows through.
So,
that's just his normal 3, right?
Yeah, that's just his standing 3. It's
so
really
good.
Cool. His heart attack is literally not, he does nothing physical at all. So, in addition to his 2 projectiles, he has this little healing aura you can put on screen, and then when he's in it, he is healing. You can actually see the effect of it adding to him. And you can do it behind. So you can put it behind you while you're doing your zoning, and the opponent, they have to get it. Even if Dr. Fate doesn't have the life lead, he can regain the life lead by healing while he's standing
in
it.
That doesn't just heal him, though, right?
No, it just heals him.
I thought it did not take away mirror.
I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
Thanks, Tyler.
Way to go, Tyler.
But we will get to something else that can do it.
Maybe that's what I'm talking about.
We will get to something
else. Oh, yeah, I'm talking about something
Blow up Central. Moving right along.
So anyway, and then he does have an up-close special move, which, even though it's an up-close special move, it plays into his defensive play style. So he has this glyph, where he actually shoots it back, and this will knock the opponent far away, and this is safe on block, and it has pushback on block. Can you block for a second?
Yeah.
Just hold down?
No.
So you can see, Dr. Fate will be pushed back. So this would be the move you use up close.
Oh.
Like, can you block for a second?
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah, so even when you're up close with Dr. Fate and you want to create space, this would be a great move to use. And the meter room one goes back even further, now you can get hit. And you can see they get pushed way back. So this is kind of your all-purpose, you're up close and you're panicking, and you want to close, you want to make that gap again, this is the move you use, the glyph.
Cool.
And that's also like one of his main punishers when you punish an unsafe attack.
Cool.
Then he has...
you want to do the down back threes?
Yeah, let's do the down back threes. He has these onks he can summon. Blink. And he summons it, and then it'll float around you. It'll never go away. And then at any point, you can hit down forward three, and it'll summon it on the opponent. That's an unblockable. It'll attach to him and do just a little bit of damage. Mm-hmm. And he can do three of them. So you're free to do it as you want. You can do one and then go throw some fireballs or go in. Yeah. Then eventually when you have all three, you can summon all three, they'll all attach, and then a pillar will go up.
That's awesome.
And then that will launch the opponent.
Now do those track?
They do. They will go to where the opponent is. They're very smart.
There's a metagame with inside playing him of trying to get them all attached.
Right. It, you know, obviously...
See, that one did not get attached.
Yeah, you have to get the opponent standing so that all three will come down. They won't just... home, but they will track on where you were before you start moving.
Right, and if you don't get hit by all three, the pillar
the
will
pillar,
not come
The
down.
Pillar is only the bonus for hitting all three. So, like Tyler said, the metagame here is taking the time, like maybe you end your combo, and then you get a pillar out. And then later you could do something and get a pillar out, and then, or not a pillar, an onk out. And then when you have all three, that's when you try to freeze them up. Maybe freeze this, or and then you get all three, and then you're gonna get your combo.
Which you didn't do. But
which I didn't do.
Well, I wanted to see some sweet combinations.
I'll get to that.
Whoa, all right.
I'll get to that. So then,
can we tell them about that real quick, combinations?
Combinations?
It's a new thing. Well, I always try to create new terminology.
Yes.
Instead of combos, corner comms was one of mine. What's on TV?
You
are.
You
need to throw the TV.
That's
you
a
are.
Classic.
The new one is combinations.
So would it now be corner combinations?
Still corner comms, no.
Okay.
So when you do a combo, it's now called a combination.
Oh.
Continue.
It
is law.
Will it catch on?
No.
Oh, okay.
Corner comms kind of catch on.
Kind of. Yeah.
So his final special move is my favorite, Sheridan's Lock, which is a magic spell he uses, which actually locks out level interactions for the opponent. You can see that Ankh in front of the background bounce there. Here, you see this little tablet. That is now locked, and Derek cannot use it.
I cannot use it.
But Dr. Fate still can.
This is one of my favorite parts of his design.
Yeah, it's so cool.
The design team was really smart and kind of went a little outside the box with some of his stuff, like kind of going into a magical realm, you know, like that's not something he does to someone else, but he's affecting again,
the environment.
If you want to talk about how you space control,
right.
Not only does he do it with his damage, he does it by not allowing the opponent to use things to help them control space.
Yes, it's so. Really, really, really creative. So his character power is dark magic.
Ooh.
You can see the bar at the end. And that shows that it's available. And then you turn it on, he turns red, and it begins to count down. And this is a buff to all of his special moves. His fireballs are now red, and they do significantly more damage.
Oh boy.
His orb...
is now...
Oh, right. His orb does significant more damage. And then it does bigger reactions for other moves. For example, his down back two will now push you back. Instead of just a little bit, it pushes you back full screen. And the meter burn one, this is the big deal, it's a full-on combo.
What? It's that's awesome. Look at this. Magic.
Oh, magical.
So you asked earlier for combos, and this is really the key to his combos.
What did I ask for?
Combination. Sorry. Jeez. Normally, Dr. Fate isn't really a combination character.
He's a pew-pewer.
Right. He's more of a keep-away character, but once he has this out, the EX down back 2 becomes his prime combo starter.
Wow, that's awesome.
His healing thing actually turns into a damaging aura, and if the opponent gets in that, they are damaged. Their health will start to drain.
Ooh, there it goes.
And you can again set it behind you if you think the opponent would maybe teleport behind you, or you can set it in front of them. And now it's a shield that the opponent, you know, they can no longer just walk through.
Right.
Another change it does is it actually changes up his throw. His throw has a different follow-up at the end, and in the corner, he gets a combination.
It's catching on. It's yeah. catching on.
Let's see.
I don't know if catching on is catching on with one person. Counts.
His throw will do a lot more damage, and then it'll bounce up.
Can I say how much crap I get for dropping combos? And this guy over here is dropping them left and right.
But he also does combos. You take a few times.
Yeah. I mean, my track record's like 50-50. Yours is like never and never.
So, I wouldn't have even said that, Tyler. That is mean.
No, that's fine. That's fine.
It also affects the aunts. The three aunts behave the same. He can get three of them, except they will become traps on the floor that hit individually. And you can do this. They don't have to hit the opponent. They'll go on the ground, and then they'll explode individually. And the cool thing is, if he has two aunts out, or one aunt, if you turn your trait on, they still turn on and turn red and turn into dark magic.
Awesome. All right. You want to do a super move for fun?
Yeah. To me, the base idea here would be when you don't have trait on, you're pure defense. You want to stay as far away as possible. But trait makes everything more aggressive. He gets his combo starter. He gets his damage curse. These become offensive. The Ankhs become offensive. So he's all about when you need to make a comeback. Or when you want to extend your life lead, that's when you turn the trait on. And then you have your 10 seconds, or however long it is, to... He's even more powerful.
To go ham, as the children say.
To go ham. Mm-hmm. So super move, even a super move is far-reaching.
Nothing is for us here. Yeah.
Cool.
There's lots of little Dr. Fates stuck
in
there.
Lots of Dr. Fates, right.
All right, cool.
All doctors.
Yeah. All PhDs.
Let us move into, go to his second.
All right, second loadout.
Second loadout, yes. So for this one, let me see what I wrote down on the old paper. Here we go. Okay, so this one we got obviously a sweet new outfit. Gear set for him. He's got some kind of some bronze looking going on and some purple. So with this one, we've given him the Seeker Orb.
Oh, this is a good one. So, the thing about Dr. Fate is a lot of his abilities modify or somewhat alter or improve a lot of his magical attacks rather than, like, totally replace them.
Yeah.
Like, for example, his orb is slower moving, but it will now actually home in on the opponent. He can delay if he wants to release it, when he wants to release it, or he can just do it. And it'll actually track him if he's jumping, if he moves around. And you can see that it's slower moving, so he can actually just go in and actually meet it. Like, he can reach the opponent before the orb does. And that allows for all kind of setups.
Yeah, if you can do them.
Tyler, go.
Roasted.
No.
You burn.
Well, Derek's also jumping around.
Yeah, that's what I do.
Yeah.
And I don't care. Okay.
Also stop it.
Okay.
And then? The second one is...
He didn't write it down.
I didn't write it down.
She did not write it
down. Nope.
Do the onks. Nope. We'll go to the
movie. Okay.
Nope. There it is.
Oh, I know. This changes his healing and his curse move. And it makes it so that it will be active if he goes into it. So let's say you have the healing orb out. If you go into it, it'll explode and immediately just give him health back. And the opposite is true of the dark one. He can have it out there, and if the opponent goes in, it immediately explodes.
Right.
So this makes it even more dangerous as a shield to use. So you can have it out, and the opponent really has to be careful. And then you could couple that with
normals in his fighting style.
Right, so just right off the bat, I mean, you'll notice he's holding the sword. Just even the way he walks is so cocky, holding it up like that, not even really in a fight stance, just kind of like, hey, look at this.
Right.
And so, you'll see just kind of like how flashy he is, right out of the bat. He doesn't just, when he attacks you, he's not just slashing, he's like throwing the sword up in the air and catching it and he'll like jump off his sword. So
right.
Some of those things, some of those elements we really try to capture in his moveset. and it just kind of worked out.
We don't need to show it all off yet.
Let's slow down, huh?
Come on. Let's go through some just cool basic attacks that we have with him, and then, you know, let's do special moves, break them down, right?
Right, so just kind of like, you know, just doing a couple like basic combos with him. You know, so he's, you know, got some things with the sword that he's doing.
Good high-low combo.
Right, so, you know, he's got some enders that are low, and then some of the things, will, some of those low enders, some of those other things will be set up, they'll be used as setups for some of the things you'll see coming soon. So, you know, but you'll notice that one of the big things about him is there's just a range on some of these normals, you know, the back two, just because of the nature of the sword and you know, all, and all that, you just got some pretty, pretty terrific range on some of these normals.
So Robin is interesting to me because I've played a little bit of him. He's very good at controlling the midground.
Yeah, he is really.
I'd also like to say just, I'm watching the stream chat. If you do have any questions specifically about Robin, if I see any that we can actually answer, I'd love to. The other thing is, somebody said, oh my gosh, damage. All this stuff isn't set yet.
Yeah, and so, yeah, that's a good thing to bring up. Like, you know, I think we're at the point right now where, you know, I don't think you can really look at damage. You know, things are changing. Things can be in flux. So it's probably not something to really
This game is still a work in progress.
Right.
We have not put it in a box yet, folks.
There might be some sound cues that are missing. It could crash. You never know.
And that's true.
It hasn't been a long time.
It's called development.
Yeah, we're still in development. So keep that in mind as you watch the stream.
So let's just break down the special moves.
Okay, so yeah, right out of the bat, you know, we've got this, this we call it a sword spin, at least I do. Just a really, really good wake-up attack, you know, just kind of really quick. Really just emphasizes the flashiness of his character in general, which is very useful, you know, overall. And then, of course, it can be, you know, meter burned here. So there's a pretty high juggle, too, so you can do a lot off that. So that's like kind of like one of the key moves that he has is called sword spin.
Okay. So that's you can meter burn that?
Yeah, he can meter burn that.
And that's good for, like, it's a really good, like, when you're on the ground, a wake-up maneuver.
Awesome
wake-up,
yeah, awesome, totally. Cool.
A couple questions real quick that I saw from the stream. Can Robin remove his hood via gear?
Ooh, good
well,
question.
Well, we are going to find out.
We'll find out soon enough, yeah.
Another question, that when we talk about gear, and they all have their sort of accessory item,
yep.
Robin's is indeed, somebody asked, his sword.
Yes, so you're going to unlock new swords as you progress, leveling up and getting new gear.
Yeah, we have a couple of the most we'll show later, too.
Okay, what else does he have here, Nick?
Okay, so one of the other things that he has is he's got this move called Assassin Strike, where it's essentially a full screen move where he just can kind of get into it pretty quickly. And you know, when he runs into you, he just does that like running slash, sword slash.
Sure.
So it's pretty far, you know, basically full screen.
You see it coming.
That's... You do see it coming, but like, you know, you can use it in multiple ways. I mean, it can be used as enders. It
can
be.
You can also trick your opponents by stopping it.
Right. Yeah.
You can cancel out of it.
You can totally. Yeah. You can cancel out of it. Yeah. So it's and it's kind of one of those ones. I guess I would compare it to like maybe Katana's run possibly, but
sure. Now can you meter burn? Oh, there it is.
Yeah, you can meter burn it. So you know, it just kind of shows like how. Yeah, he's not just gonna slash you. He's gonna stab you with that sword. It's just a brutal looking
kind of
move.
Meter burning it. Once he does that kick, still kind of puts him back in that mid range as well.
Yeah, he does.
Where Damien likes to be.
He has a lot of really long reaching sword stabs that help him control that for sure.
Yeah. Now let's go into his Birdarang.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. So yeah, the Birdarang, you know, is a really interesting projectile. Here it is. So really it's kind of like a smart gadget device that, you know, kind of homes in a little bit to some degree on the victim.
I've played against 16 bits and it's tricky. Like, you gotta watch when you jump, you gotta watch, it's very tricky.
Right, and that's a pretty good example, you know, so when you jump up, like, basically what it will do is it will loop around, and then at the point where it's done looping, it'll basically track the last position you were at.
Right.
So it's not like full-on homing, like, oh, I'm gonna always adjust my position, but wherever it is at the point where it's about to cross the loop, that's wherever your character, whatever the position is where it's gonna go.
Alright, and it too has a meter burn, which is
let's see that
super
meter burn.
Badass.
Right, so it's got this meter burn here, so we've got these bombs that come out, you know, as she can, like, launch the guy with it, you know, like, do, you know, other things into
that,
of course.
You can catch
those
from that, too.
Yeah. Yeah, and so that'll hit low, too, as well.
So,
Alright, and then he's got his kicking thing. What do we call that?
That's called swoop.
The swoop.
Okay, so he's got this move here, right? So he's got this dive kick kind of move, which is cool because it's got like different ranges on it. It's like, you know, got a little short range and long range and stuff like that.
And traditional dive kicks you actually do in the air.
You do in the air. This one is gonna be only on the ground, you know, it's useful, you know, can like you can go jump over projectiles, it hits overhead. But then he gets onto either side of you too. And at this point it's slightly pretty advanced.
Does it have a meter burn?
It does.
This is my favorite question. This is my ongoing question.
You're getting good at asking it too.
Yes, thank you.
Can we turn off the input display real quick? If we get people asking in stream on the game to.
Oh, all right. Practice options. See it? Do you
button
see
log.
It? Button
log.
Am I going down or up?
Up. Stop, down.
Up.
Stop, go.
All right.
Off. Okay, cool.
All right. Okay.
There we go. Awesome.
Okay, so he also has a meter burn on that as well.
And that can go from different distances.
Right, it can go different distances. You can do like a short version, and then, you know, somebody sees it and it's like, oh, let me do something about that, and then.
Does he have any other special attacks, just normal specials, that you want to go over? We did the run.
We did the run.
Oh, he has the air flip, too.
Oh, okay, yeah, so, yeah, he has this, I guess it's called, I don't know what it's called, actually. It's called, like, sword spin.
It's air. The same move as the sword flip with your feet, but you can just in the air.
Right.
It's the same inputs.
Yeah. So yeah, I guess that would be an air sword flip.
Yep.
So it's just kind of like an air overhead, just like a super flashy, air overhead attack that's got like a, using the sword, so it's got like pretty good range on it. And then of course, yeah, that one's got a meter burn version too, so it's a pop-up.
Could you wait for me to ask for it next time, please? Thank you.
Let's go over the his
character power.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, so. So, you know, Damien's got this interesting power. I guess I could kind of compare it to maybe what Green Arrow did in Injustice 1. So it's got like, he's got this gadget that has like three, it's kind of like three different gadget functions. And so you can put it down like this. So it's just hit the gimmick button and it comes out. And it's there, and you know, you can see the meter draining. And this one is the version where he can teleport to it. So it's like, he can put this thing down at any point. And then essentially teleport directly to it. So, I mean, you can use it in many ways. Like, you could, you know, put it down, you know, save it for later, start a combo. You could, you know, in situations where you wanted to be, you know, safe, you could teleport back to it. So, it can be used like that.
And that can be thrown at different distances.
Close, different distances,
medium,
yeah.
Far,
different distances.
All that. Behind the opponent, teleport behind him.
Right. But there are two other versions of the character power.
Two other versions. Okay, so, you know, The one we just saw was the version where you can teleport to it, and then so then you've got the other one, this the red version, which is just a just, you know, straight up bomb, you know, so it hits low. This is one of the few attacks where he actually hits low, and so that will just like kind of launch the guy. So it's a, you know, pretty quick, just normal standard bomb attack.
Right.
And then this one's kind of interesting, this bluish looking one. So what he can do is place it behind the victim, and call it back at any point in time. And it will always hit behind them. So, I mean, you could, there's a lot of setup potential for that too. So you can, you know, somebody's jump in or somebody's, you know.
Sure.
You know, they always have to be thinking about where that version, that Batarang is. So they can't get caught by it.
Cool.
May I try now to show my combo and see how many times it takes?
First, I'd like to ask the stream, how many times you think it'll take Tyler before he actually nails the combo? I'm going with at least five. Minimum of five.
Nick? When he showed it to me yesterday, he asked me the exact same question and he hit it the first time, so you never know.
How many tries are you going with, Nick?
This time, I would say probably about three.
Three times.
He's going to hit it on his first.
7, 16, 12, 5, 5, 7, 4 million.
Yeah, that's realistic. 130.
One person said one.
Okay.
So the stream
jitters. One person has faith in you.
I've told you about the stream jitters.
Here we go. There's one.
Does that count?
That totally counts.
Yeah, that does.
There's two. That wasn't it. That you were improvising on that one. That's three. Oh.
Here you go.
Bam!
Nick Nicholson was the winner.
Nick Wright with four.
Nice.
Nick Wright with four. And right. Here's why I missed it.
Oh, the TV was laggy, of course.
Right. No, yeah. I was pushing down forward two, not down back two.
Oh.
Which does that.
Sure.
Because I just did it.
Sure.
Yep.
Sure. So, all right.
My bad.
So everybody that guessed four, you're winners. You're going to get prizes. Just kidding. That's a lie.
We do, though, after you go away, we'll have a giveaway from our good friends at DC here today.
Great.
We're going to talk about that after... Now, particularly, if we don't leave yet.
No.
More things to show. For instance,
Super Moves!
People want to see a Super Moves.
swagger.
Yeah, yeah, pretty swagger.
Super swagger.
That's what he does. Yeah, that's what
cool.
he does.
A couple people on stream thought my combo was cool.
Really?
Really? Pretty good. Wow. Pretty good. Pretty good.
Nick, do you want to try and do a super swaggy combo? I know you showed us some stuff earlier.
Probably, you know,
not
whatever I did earlier, I guess. I mean, yeah. Just a couple things as
we
I play.
We'll just describe it to you as we go.
It does this, this, and it looked nothing like what Travis did.
I'm going to do that again.
Okay, no, he's not.